Well, it happens in 13 days, and some are calling it the Great Crash. I'm calling it kind of a coincidence. Now, you guys are going to need your tinfoil hats for this one. You have Bill Gates, Meta CEO, Mark Zuckerberg, BlackRock, Larry Fink, Morgan Stanley, CEO, Ted, and a whole lot more people. Did I mention cue the fire? And I think your time's up. So all of the elites are meeting in one place, just like they did back in 2020, right around the same time frame. What a coinkydink, but it's a wedding this time, including Microsoft. So we got Bill Gates, we did that, CEO Larry Fink, Blackstone, we got Disney, Bob showing up, let's see, Trump, not the Trump. We have Morgan Stanley, Bank of America, Moynihan. Actually, I just saw him in Aspen. Who else? Well, can't use that name. You guys know that one. Yeah, you don't want to say that on YouTube. Actually, true story, my friend did get a strike for using that name on YouTube and gave truthful information that was in the media. It's like, do you see this? Actually, one of them just died. But in this video, we are talking about the emergency lending program from the Fed. And we're going to see, is there something there? And I say, maybe. I'll show you what to look for. Okay, all right. And then I'll show you other things. It's coming in from Sir Lancelot. Powell ends the BTFP emergency bank liquidity on, could they have made it a little bit shorter? March 11th. So we're a few weeks away. And it begins failing from that date. And Powell did the same thing January 2020 when he pulled the emergency repo interventions away. And lo and behold, third time's a charm, we had Hank Paulson pulled the repo away September 2008, right when the crash began. Well, I'm not gonna say it's gonna happen. I'm just saying it looks like a duck, okay? It's walking like a duck, it quacks like a duck, and this was this was after the market crashed with the same everything, the same parties, the same everyone gets together.
I suppose, yeah.
Okay. Mr. Powell, I'm going to project a picture up here so that the audience can see, but I'm also going to hold it up for you. Is this you, Mr. Powell?
That is.
Where are you?
That's a party after the alfalfa dinner, an after party that I went to.
Where was that party held?
It was at Jeff Bezos's home.
At Jeff Bezos' home, and when was it taken?
Excuse me?
When was this picture taken?
Saturday night after the alfalfa dinner.
And just following this, where you guys all meet in one place, the stock market crashes. Now, Jerome did have good excuses when asked, like, who did you talk to? He's like, talk to who? I'm sure we're going to have the same thing repeated over and over. Did you talk to this guy? No. This guy? Nope. This guy? Nope. No one. This just did breaking news, also known as a breaking coincidence. Jeff Bezos, Jamie Dimon, and Mark Zuckerberg are selling everything. That's a little much, Bravo. Chill the fire there for a second. Okay. They're selling a lot. Have sold stock. And some of these guys have never even sold their... Jamie, it's like this is a first. Worth $9 billion. They might think the markets can't go much higher. Or they're going to crash. Some of you might be thinking, Bravo, is it going to crash? Is it going to crash? The answer is, I don't know. Even if it does, I'm still going to go in. Actually, just have to wait for that, right? That beat down. This reminds me of that January. Actually, that was that October where we all piled in right about there on that swing trade. Wrote it up, took profit, wrote it up a little bit more. Now we're just like, what are we doing? I am waiting for a pullback. So if there is, like in 1929, okay, comes up, pullback, I'm going to swing this to the top. I just will. 1987, same thing. Same, everything's lining up. This is actually a chart from GOAT, but we've all seen this before. 1987, wait for the pullback. Actually, you guys are going to get some good swings in on this one. 1929 would have been a good swing. You just probably don't want to be that old. Another, 87, swing up, take profit. Swing up, take profit. Here we go. Another swing, take profit. So we are currently right there with a probability of a swing down. Okay, swing up, get in, ride it up. Take profit, beat down, can't go higher, blow off top, game over. But then the question is, are we there yet? And I'm going to say, it just feels so close. Everything's lining up. But always be in and always be out as March 11th. Here we go. Fed to allow the emergency bank lending program to expire. Now, this does not mean that all of your banks now have to pony up the billions that they borrowed. No, it's actually, it's in sections. Just as fast as they could cancel one emergency program, we're going to start up a new one. Because the Federal Reserve has new tools. The only tool that they have, this is it, loan. Would you like a loan? Yes, sir, we would like a loan. Because the entire system is only debt loans. And that's all they're going to do. They're just going to create another loan program. As insolvent as the Fed is, the banks are, you are, the whole system is, we'll just do more loans. That should solve the problem. But also, your problem will never be solved if you are not acting like, well, don't act like, be nothing like them. But learn how to buy, sold, make billions, rinse and repeat. Just like last year, same time, look at this. I put this on my watch list. This was my bear market watch list. Friday, February 17th. I said, short this company that you maybe you've never heard of it. It's called SIVB at over $300 a share, now at zero. So now a year later, with everything repeating itself. Also, if you want to look at my watch list, link in the description, I give you 7 days free. You could trial, look at it. Guys, every day from my options to my bull market to my bear market, I posted just for you. This was my February 6th, played out good. Nine count came on. I think this one, what did we make on this one? Only 109%. That wasn't so bad. Another one at 254%. There's so many options you guys could do in this market. You could do the while you're swing trading some up, you're swing trading some down, you're doing options. Actually, for those of you that missed it yesterday, it's I guess it's over today. This is it, 24-hour sale. I said, whichever course you want for $199, minus the Amazon one I'm doing for like $99 or $100. You can pick and choose as we have a historical down day in the market. Look at that. S&P 500 crashed. The NASDAQ crashed. The Dow crashed. Actually, they just put on a big fart. Also, yesterday I told you guys about silver. I said we have one of the biggest head and shoulders. Actually, it's inverse. I think I forgot to use the word inverse. It's opposite. But guys, what I did forget to mention, which it was actually up. I think it was up the 200. You're still under the 200. So that means if you break this line, you could go so far down. You better hope it tests that line, it heads back up, and then you could carry this line up over here, which you would understand how to do that because you're in my, if you took my bull market course, yes. Bear market course this way, bull up, bear down. My daughter actually went viral on that. She's like, look, see, like that. That's a bull up, a bear, down. She actually looked for that video, couldn't find it, but I found me, so that's good. But now with wrapping up stocks, and I'll get to the banking thing, what to look for when it all goes to hell in a handbasket. But let's just wrap this up with the S&P 500. I added the 500 there at record highs. Well, it's actually S&P 5, maybe 3. If you guys are in the broader markets, you're like, why isn't my portfolio going up? Hedge funds are again dumping stocks. Now, should you be dumping stocks? Should you be shorting stocks? I wouldn't recommend it if you're above the 200. I know a lot of people, sometimes they get excited. They're like, oh, the market's down, time to short. That is not the time to short. That's actually probably a good time to get wrecked. Shorting tech at furious pace, Goldman Prime. And you guys could make a killing on shorting NVIDIA. This would be a great one. But if you are wrong, you're going to get your face ripped off. And you, again, look, see, I turn it yellow for you. You're above it. I know a few days ago, you know, my purple nurple's on. Bravo, it's one candle close. I'm like, earnings. You sure? You sure you want to do that? I think once you've done it long enough, 673 goes up to 800. A move like that would just wipe you out. You're just like, that's it. I guess trading is not for me. And I say it is paper trading, but you just need to know what you're doing. So many people just have no clue. But here we go. So Fed allow emergency big bank lending program to expire on March 11th. I care. I don't care. Fed raises rates on emergency loan program to start arbitrage, which the banks were just like, okay, so we can get a loan for this, get a loan for that. We make the difference. Perfect. But now let's look, and this is what I look for, in is it legit or not? First, assets, liquidity, and credit facilities. That's what that this is currently what is going on. This was we're going to save the system with loans, right? All the way to the very tippy top where it's starting to chill out a little bit. But that this is not what I am looking at. The two that I'm looking at coming in at the balance sheet. Here's one of them. It's the liabilities. That's actually cooling off. See, when we went from there all the way up there, I got a little scarred there. This is recessionary levels. But I will tell you, the one that I look for is this bad guy. This will tell you when all hell breaks loose. A recession, see that? That was 2008. This is when everyone runs to the Fed. And here was one. Here was your banking collapse. But now you want to know where are we at today? Let me move myself over to this side. Sorry about my big black thing. It just dangles on the screen. Let me move this over so you guys can see this area. If you see a spike on this, and now I'm at fred.stlouisfed.org, series WLFCFLPCL. I'm sure you just wrote that down. But you can subscribe. Click the subscribe button because I am watching that over that way. To see if the banks are running to the Fed using this. And as of right now, I'm still not seeing it. But all I'm seeing with 20 seconds left is everyone's gathering right now, breaking news. So that's happening right now. The same as every single time. But it was for a wedding. It was, what a quinky dink. And other things that I see. With 10 seconds left is I still see you having to pay a heck a lot more in taxes. Isn't that sad? You don't have any expenses? See, remember, you start a business. Oh, your time's up. Looks like you can't start a business. Right? You make these things. You make $100,000. You spend $100,000 on business expenses. You pay taxes on whatever you make. And that is how it all ends, and that is how it all burns down. I just want to make sure that you are on the right side of this field, either making money up, down, or options, which those are the big numbers. That's quickly hurry up and move yourself there. When this thing burns, you're gonna be very wealthy. Sounds crazy, but that's when everyone really makes their money. All the elites move their money, but you know that because you subscribed. You may even hit the like button. But anywho, you guys, love you, and I will report back tomorrow. See you tomorrow.